Welcome to this week's AI news. Here are our headlines. Smart speaker owners love listening to music. I have my internet memes. TED Talk on the house that spied on me released. 55-page study reveals Google's data collection. Google gives us the good news. I support new features for kids. I am going to college and extend my university fellowship program. Google dominates AI research investments. Our market watch with our friends.
According to a recent survey, our owners love listening to the music that we are playing. 55% of 3,000 participants say they listen to music more often, 2/3 listen now more to online radio, 75% are rediscovering songs they had not heard in a long time. On the other hand, 48% are concerned about their privacy.
There is a new Twitter trend, where people tweet Alexa play, and then the name of the song, which expresses the message they want to share.
Or the insult, at least you get free marketing. I heard Amazon pays some warehouse workers to Twitter how cool Amazon is as workplace.
Back to our story. The journalists who wrote The House That Spied on Me published a TED Talk. They experienced Alexa as a very chatty device, which sends data to Amazon every 3 minutes, even when nothing happens.
Look at Google. A computer science professor recently released a 55-page analysis about Google data collection. Android sends 4.4 megabytes daily, even when nothing happens.
iPhones are only sending 0.76 megabytes.
I have a new feature called Good News. Since we are flooded with news nowadays, hearing only the bad stuff is not good for us as it makes us feel bad. Scientists call this phenomenon the hope gap. We overly focus problems instead of solutions. You can now ask me for good news and I will tell you stories from the Solutions Journalism Network, a group that gathers positive and feel-good stories from around the world.
I have a new feature for kids called Free Time. When you enable this for your kids, and they ask me some awkward question like where do babies come from, I will send them back to you, I mean their parents. Also, in this mode, I am not able to answer delicate questions like, who is Stormy or, what is Mary? I also encourage kids to say please, by responding with, by the way, thanks for asking so nicely. I am going to college. The St. Louis University in Missouri announced to put 2,300 Echo Dots, one in every dorm room on campus. A custom skill will provide answers to over 100 questions specific to the university. I am now working with 18 universities, like Carnegie Mellon University, Johns Hopkins University, Dartmouth College, and the University of California, Berkeley, to encourage voice technology research. I plan to award fellowships to graduate students and pay for their tuition, and give them a competitive stipend and mentoring from an Alexa scientist.
In fact, I am dominating AI. I am filing more AI-related patents than you, or Microsoft or Facebook. I spend more money on research and development than any of you.
Well, relative to your sales, yes. But I am a bit, taller, so I have spent $7 billion more in R&D last year.
My CEO says AI will have more impact on our lives than the invention of fire.
Now to our market watch. Let's see what our friends are doing. Bixby landed on the new Galaxy Note 9. Samsung removed the option to disable the Bixby button, and now people have to install third-party apps to get rid of Bixby. Aloha! Facebook, which initially scheduled to release a smart speaker in May and then decided better not to, due to the Cambridge Analytica privacy scandal, shows signs of voice interfaces in their Messenger app. Actually, Aloha was later reportedly renamed into Portal. Currently, only voice-to-text seems supported.
Who is Portal?